Well, good morning. This is another storm cleanup. My friend Chris with High Country Tree Service. We got that stump to get out. Got those stumps over there to get out and get them hauled off, and a little firewood loaded, and a little bit of general cleanup. Let's get going. Chris is gonna whack the extra amount off that stump. That's just dead weight. A lot of people think that helps for leverage, and the added weight actually is counterproductive over what leverage you have for something this size. Smaller stuff, yeah, it helps, but.
Nah.
That was almost the wrong thing.
Nah, I was just discussing that on the camera that I don't really need it for leverage. It's just the added weight is worse than the gain of leverage.
Yeah,
so.
I just thought I'd get it off right before. Okay.
Thank you.
Whatever you think. And then,
okay, let's. Got here, even though it blew over, that only took the stumps out on one side, so pretty good root right there. I didn't add it into the video because I figured it was just kind of a subject that would bring controversy, so I left it alone. But then I started getting questions about it. But I used the ripper on my last job only because the logs were so big that I ripper with the curvature of it is easier to get a hold of the logs with. I see a lot of comments on one of the Facebook Kubota excavator groups that I'm on about you have to have a ripper for digging stumps. I guess on real shallow rooted stuff it would work good, but these bigger roots and these pines and stuff that go down deep where you actually, well, the other day I did one and I dug about 6 feet down on it to get it to let go. Ripper don't dig. And when you're trying to pry to break the roots, the ripper, like right here, I'm using the bucket, pushing down on the bucket to get extra leverage to break the root. The ripper just buries in the ground and it doesn't break the root. So, in my opinion, and I'm sticking to it, the bucket does a much better, the 12-inch bucket does a much better job. Again, I see people talking about that they use their 2-foot bucket and stuff like that. You're spreading your pressure out over such a large area, it's a lot harder to break the roots. I've dug bucket, you know, when I'm building road, I use my 30-inch bucket, and I don't carry another bucket with me way up a hillside, so I dig out with the 30-inch bucket because that's what I've got on the machine. The 12-inch substantially outdoes the 30-inch for digging stumps. And we got her loose. And we got to get some dirt. dirt off of it so I can pick it up. That's heavy.
On the fact that we had three.
never get them loaded. I can pick up a lot, but I can't pick up both of those. I got your axe. Seen that just as I threw it. Thank you. covered by windshield. I didn't see that.
So,
okay.
Well, yeah, because we're good on the road. I don't want to
break your sports. Okay. Set that on the back like that, and then be sure the doors will close. There we go. I'm going to lift this one right over it. Theoretically. That's the plan. See how our plan works out. That's how a professional would maybe do it. If there was a professional around, they could tell us. You know? Cleaning our roots up. Jell-O. Get this stuff here?
Yeah, the tires are getting squishy.
Or do you want to stop? Stop? Okay.
Yeah, no, I haven't worked this in a while.
You want those on the
other side, C5, this is a little squishy.
I can throw that on the far side.
That's good stuff right there.
It is. Let's throw it on the far side. it's worth a blown tire.
Oh, great. Just, wonderful. Thank
just,
you.
Just run it on the rim.
Boy, I haven't checked the air on this side. It was away from my compressor. The other two look fine on the other side. Like, oh, that's got air in it.
It's got air in it. They're still round.
Oh, my grief. Jeremy said just keep loading on there. Okay, yeah, we're definitely done.
Yeah, we'll stop there.
How's the other side?
Well, that is the conclusion for today. So, everyone, thanks for watching. Please subscribe, hit that like button, and we will catch you tomorrow where we're mulching.